Friends, today we are going to learn the practical to find out the effectiveness of heat exchanger. In our setup, there is a heat exchanger called parallel and counterflow heat exchanger. This is the setup. This is the control panel for that. There are different types of heat exchanger, but in our lab, you are going to study the effectiveness of parallel and counterflow. The different heat exchanger are shell and tube heat exchanger, compact heat exchanger, plate type heat exchanger, etc. To find out the effectiveness of the heat exchanger, first of all, you want a heating supply, heater. Now see, this is the heater supply, which is connected to this tank. Here, if you connect to this power supply, the heat will be supplied to this tank. Okay? And if you open this knob, then the water will flow from this side. And this is the hot water. The hot water will flow from this side and it will go. Now see, this is a thermocouple. Here T2 is the temperature for hot water inlet. Okay, then this water passes through the tube. Now see here, you can see this is a concentric tube, means tube in tube, means through the inside tube the hot water passes and through the outside tube the cold water passes. When the hot water passes through the inner diameter tube, and that will pass like this, and that will go here. Means here, if you close this knob, then here is the scale for measuring the flow rate of a hot water. Just you have to open your stopwatch and just measure the time required for a particular height, and by getting these two, you will get the flow rate for hot water. Remember, as the hot water is passing through this, you have to continuously open this knob. Okay? Now, what is meant by parallel flow and counterflow heat exchanger? Now, see here. In parallel flow heat exchanger means the direction of hot water and cold water both are same. Whereas in counterflow heat exchanger, the direction of hot water, if you allow this direction for hot water, then the cold water direction should be like this. Okay? Means the direction of hot water and cold water are different. Now, first of all, we will see how to operate for parallel flow heat exchanger. Now, as I already told you, now the cold water direction, see here, the cold water direction should be this. Okay? Means this is the pipe. See here, this is the pipe through which the cold water comes, and from here, this is the pipe through which the cold water comes, and from here, pause. As you know, that the direction of cold water and hot water are same in parallel flow heat exchanger. The direction of hot water in this setup is already fixed. We can't change the direction of hot water. That is from my right side to left side. Hence, to have a parallel flow heat exchanger, your cold flow direction should be also from right side to left side. Okay? Now, this is the cold water inlet. Okay? This is the cold water inlet, and the water should come from here and through this pipe. Okay? Through this pipe, see, it should go like this. Okay, it should go like this. And see, This is for hot water. You don't have to consider this. Okay. The cold water will come from here. It will get heated and it will go through here. Okay. Means here you can get the mass flow rate of the cold water as well as temperature, outlet temperature of the cold water. Okay. Means by using thermometer, here you can measure the temperature of cold water outlet. Okay. Now see, this is the thermocouple. This is the thermocouple for measuring the temperature, inlet temperature of the cold water. Okay. Now, as I already told you, the cold water is coming from here and it is going through here. Means this valve should be opened. Okay. And this wall should be open. Okay. These two walls should be open. See here. These two walls should be open. Just now it is closed now. But once you have started the parallel flow arrangement, these two walls should be open. When you open this wall, the water will flow like this, and when you open this, the water will come like this. But at the same time, this knob and this knob should be closed. Okay? This knob and this knob should be closed. Means you can say that this red color walls should be open and this blue color wall should be closed. Okay? And after that, you have to measure the mass flow rate of the cold water, and here you can measure the temperature of the outlet temperature of the cold water. Here just you have to measure four temperatures: hot water inlet, hot water outlet, cold water inlet and cold water outlet. These four temperatures you have to measure. Okay. Now the next arrangement is for counterflow heat exchanger. As I told you, the hot water is passing from my right side to left side. Hence the cold water should go from left side to right side for a counterflow heat exchanger. Then what you have to do, you have to open. See, what cold water is coming here, the cold water should come like this. Okay, and that will go like this. Okay, means from here it should have entry and from here it should have exit. Means through this path, whatever the walls are coming, that should be opened, and apart from that, remaining wall should be closed. This is a simple arrangement. As water should come like this, means this wall should be open, this should be closed. Once the water comes from here, it is going like this, and water should go like this. Means this wall should be open. Okay, this is open, and remaining wall should be closed. Simple arrangement is there. You have to just open these two knobs and remaining wall should be closed. And again, by using these thermocouples and here scale, you have to measure the flow rate as well as the temperature. This is the arrangement for a now thus I have explained you the construction and how to do the working for parallel and counterflow heat exchanger. Now in next video, we will see the exact practical and calculation. Thank you very much.